Hi, my name is Dr. Earl Turner. I'm a licensed psychologist, psychology professor, and also founder and executive director of Therapy for Black Kids. We are going to be discussing the importance of career exploration with Black youth. Let the audience know a little bit about yourself and the work that you do related to career development.
All right, well, I have Dr. Earl. So my name is Tanisha Turner, and my passion is the development of young people. I currently work as the Director of Career and Leadership at a local university here. And my work, I'm able to transcend my work to my passion and my purpose by working with children and young professionals to explore and learn more about careers and different pathways where they can find their definition of success. So again, thank you for having me, and yeah.
Great. So, you know, I started Therapy for Black Kids because I wanted to provide a resource to Black families about exploring a lot of different issues that can help their kids develop in a healthy way. Part of it is sort of mental health, but also just sort of life, self-esteem, and all of those other aspects that are important to childhood. And so I wanted to have this conversation with you just to talk a little bit more about career development and why that's important for Black kids specifically. So before we jump into the importance of it, can you talk with us a little bit about like what is career exploration?
So career exploration is just, and for young people, we like to say career awareness, but it's as simple as the statement is, making sure that children are aware of the different options and paths that they have. You know, when I was coming up, when we were coming up, the options were doctor, lawyer, dentist, firefighter, police officer, military. But there are so many options for our young people. And it's not that we are not aware. We're not aware at a young age. And I think that's what hinders sometimes our progress, because it takes so long for us to know what's really out there. So my goal is to help parents and children start at an early age to develop and become conscious of different pathways that they can pursue to, like I said before, find their definition or their level of success.
Yeah, that's a really important point. And, you know, one of the things that I've, you know, you mentioned some of the paths that are oftentimes talked about are things like doctors and lawyers and things like that. And, you know, for me growing up, watching The Cosby Show and things like that gave us some of that representation about different options and things that we can go into as careers or a different world in terms of like promoting, you know, going to college and things like that. So I think today there are some shows that highlight some of those things. But as you mentioned, there are a lot of different options that kids can explore. And it doesn't have to be sort of those doctor lawyer types of careers or even thinking about sports, for example. I think a lot of kids want to get involved in athletics, which is important and helpful, but to reach that level of like the NBA or NFL, it's only going to be a few that can get into that specific career path.
Right, right. You never think about who's there to support those doctors. We have physician assistants, we have anesthesiologists, we have nurses, we have so many others who are within the medical field who are still able to fulfill their purpose in the world and also make a good living and do things that they love. So I think it's very important that we spotlight those careers early. So that students can know that they don't have to wait and go to college and change their major 20 times to figure out that path. And it's okay, because a lot of us did that. But if we know better, we can do better. Not only does that save us time, but it also saves money. And as you know, college is so expensive. If we can find ways to reduce the tag on college, then I think more people will be willing to go. So if we start engaging our children early on in these things, I think we would definitely have a better outlook on success and our future careers.
I think that having those different options is helpful early on in someone's life. And we talk about careers, I think, particularly like the college trajectory, usually maybe middle school, high school, for mm-hmm. most families. And so I'm wondering, like, what do you think in terms of, like, when is it a good age to even begin to have conversations with kids about, hey, what do you want to be when you grow up?
You know, it doesn't have to be as formal as what do you want to be when you grow up. It can be something as simple as, what do you like to do? What do you enjoy? We find different ways and different avenues to conduct that career awareness without making it a formal process. Taking children on field trips on the weekend, whether you go to the Space and Science Museum, or maybe you engage in some type of STEM activity. There are so many different options now. Maybe you visit a firehouse, or take a tour of a nursing of a hospital, or just find different ways to explore those different careers without making it so formal. And watch what makes them light up. What are they doing? Are they using their hands? Are they reading more? Or are they happy when they're viewing information in different ways? Find ways to do informal inventories with your children when they are younger. And once you see that in them, then you can start to help develop and nourish those specific characteristic traits. But it's about helping to develop those things in the children at a young age. I think that's very important. And you mentioned, you know, changing majors. The same thing, you know, I was always told, well, you know, you make a good lawyer. And for so long, I went to school to become an attorney. Well, I did an internship and I realized I don't want to do that, you know? And that was like my third year in college when I realized I did not want to become an attorney. So I didn't have to take so long. I was able to use those same skill sets that everyone saw in me and use those to become an effective educator, trainer, leader. So it's a method of finding ways to promote the skills and the passions that your children have to do something that they will love in the future.
Absolutely. That's a really good point. You know, in my work as a therapist, you know, sometimes I have parents who are talking with their child about, you know, things that they want them to do when they grow up. And sometimes it's like, you know, well, as an adult, what types of things that I want to do that I didn't have a chance to do. So now I want to sort of expose my kids to those types of things. And as you sort of touched on, I really think it is important that you sort of give them opportunities and options to just sort of explore different things within the world and see, like, what do they like and what do they really enjoy, as opposed to trying to maybe push or maybe even to sort of encourage them down a particular sort of career path. So for everyone that's joining, we're talking about career explorations with youth, and we'll have a chance for you to ask us some questions in a little bit as well. But I want to go back to a question that I had about sort of representation. And so